Hello, this is Tommy. Welcome back to Chatomics. In today's video, I'm going to talk about what to prepare for bioinformatics in the age of AI. And we know AI is eating up the world. In this video, I'm going to share with you five foundational skills that you need to master to be better prepared. For example, generative AI is designing novel drug molecules in minutes instead of months. Of course, whether that new molecule, new drug passed the ultimate test, which is clinical trial, is another story for another day. AI can also generate a lot of high quality code. However, here is the catch. AI does not understand the biology the way you do. It generates codes based on the patterns, because it's trained on all the code based on, for example, on the website, on GitHub, on Stack Overflow. So it probably does not know the biological logic. And there's a report showing that 80% of the AI generated bioinformatics code need actually human review. Okay, and this benchmark called BioCoder reveals that even ChatGPT-4 achieves only 50% of accuracy on complex bioinformatics tasks. And I will show you today exactly how to master foundational skills to judge whether the AI-generated code will actually work for your biological data. When AI actually gets biology wrong, right? I'm going to give you some real examples here. For example, like one AI tool that generates this DNA sequence analysis script, but treat the zero-based coordinate system as one-based. This is a very classical off by one error that is actually plagued in bioinformatics for years. Even within the bioinformatics certain tools, it's not consistent. And I actually have a blog post on zero-based coordinate system and one-based coordinate system, and make sure you read that blog post. I will have the link in the description of this video. For example, bat files, those are zero-based, they start counting at zero, and VCL files, they start counting at one. For coordinate system, the chromosome from the first base to the last base, and some formats that start with zero, some formats start with one, and make sure you understand those differences. Those are not actually coding bugs, right? Those are just biological misconceptions that could invalidate the entire research project. And because AI actually trained the data in the web, and many of those codes were wrong to begin with, so it's sometimes AI cannot figure that out. Okay, next. Those are the five foundations. Let me start with first one, understanding the data formats. And bioinformatics is notorious for various different file formats, right? For example, you have FASTQ files and FASTA files, right? When AI generates code to pass the FASTQ files, you need to quickly recognize if it's handling the quality score correctly, right? If it's managing pair entries properly. You need to understand the file format, single end versus pair end, right? FASTA versus FASTQ. And there are a lot of other file formats, VCF, BEN, GFF, and BAT files. So those are the basic file formats that are commonly used in bioinformatic analysis. You should start with those foundation knowledge rather than just copy-paste in any AI code. And foundation number two, statistical methods and assumptions, right? Statistics, this is where actually AI can get really dangerous. For example, AI may generate a t-test for non-normal data or use correlation when actually causation analysis is needed. And the RNA-seq analysis, you want to understand why we need normalization, why just library size normalization is not enough, why you need to do this variance stabilization normalization, for example, in DSeq too, because large genes with large counts, they tend to have large variants, right? And you need to deeply understand why you need to apply multiple testing correction. So when you are testing thousands or tens of thousands of genes at once, you will actually find significant p-values just by random, because p-value is a random variable. I also have another blog post focused on p-value, understanding p-value and also FDR, multiple test correction. Okay, so The dangerous part is that the code can run without errors, giving you very beautiful but wrong results. You really need solid understanding of statistics, right? Check normality assumptions, and also understand why, for example, RPKM versus TPM matters in the expression analysis, right? In RNA-seq analysis. TPM stands for transcript per million. RPKM stands for reads per kilobase per million. And I also have another blog post for that. Condition number three, biological logic validation. This is your secret weapon because you are a bioinformatician. You have the bio in your title, or a computational biologist. You are a biologist. You need to understand the biology to begin with, right? For example, you can do a reverse complement your DNA sequence and 5' to 3', then 3' to 5'. And protein coding sequences need to be divisible by 3, because 3 letters corresponding to one amino acid, right? And also splicing sites should follow, in general, 99% should follow this GTAG rules. This is the chemotype, the spliceosome actually recognize it. Those are the basic biology knowledges that you have to use to validate whether the results make any biological sense. There are also domain knowledges in biology that can help you to guard for those wrong answers. For example, if you find a protein that should be only seen on cell surface, but you find them, it's really high expression in the nucleus, for example, that's something wrong. Or maybe a transcription factor, they only binds, for example, open chromatin regions, but then you find that it binds to the closed regions, then something is wrong, right? Every line of AI generated code should pass your biological intuition. Foundation number four, this is actually a code review checklist. First of all, you need to actually report. Are all the parameters and methods clearly documented from the AI generated code? Does it execute without any errors on your test data? Whether it's reliable, does it handle edge cases, like empty files or file formats formatted? Reproducibility, if you just give the same input, does it give you the same output every time? Readability, can other bioinformaticians understand it? Usually it has actually a lot of comments, so make sure you include those. Lastly, a release, is it like version controlled or properly packaged? This framework has saved me actually countless hours of debugging AI generated disasters. Of course, all this requires you to have really solid programming foundation skills, right? Still, you need to start with Python or Unix. Those foundational programming skills will help you in the long term, right? You need to be able to judge whether the AI generated code is correct or not. Okay, so foundation number five, you need to be able to test. There are a couple of strategies here. First of all, you never just trust the AI code without testing it. For example, if you are doing variant calling and you use AI to generate a pipeline to call the variants, and because genome in a bottle, there's a reference data that is well known, and you can use that as your positive control, for example. And if the pipeline cannot even find the variant that is already known in this reference data sets, right? Genome in a bottle, this known variant, it's broken. Of course, you should have positive controls, but you should also have negative controls. Right? For example, if your codes is for doing sequence alignment, and you have two identical sequences, you should give you a high identity score, 100%. But if you use completely random sequences, there's a negative control and you should get a low score. So those are positive and negative controls just doing wet lab experiments, right? If AI generated code fails those basic tests, you caught a major bug before it corrupts your research. Okay. Those are the common AI mistakes and some red flags. First of all is the the confusion of the coordinate system, one-based versus zero-based, this actually can derail your results. Strand orientation blindness, for example, in biology, you have forward, reverse strand, 5' to 3', 3' to 5'. AI probably sometimes can make it wrong. File format mixing, you need to understand differences between different file formats, TFF versus BAT, SAN versus BAN. And statistical method misuse, you need to have a solid foundation of statistics. You can recognize when AI is using the wrong test. Memory managed disasters, sometimes AI probably love to load the entire genome into memory when actually streaming would work. When you see those patterns, immediately dig deeper into the code and try to optimize it. And the good thing is that when you recognize the pattern, you can ask AI, for example, oh, you are using too much memory, can you please revise it and do the streaming? And AI can actually help you to revise the code. So your next steps to AI bioinformatics mastery, trust, but verify everything, right? Join reproducible research movements. I'm a big fan of reproducible computing. Use version control, document everything. It's probably even better if you can document what kind of prompt you used to generate the code. There's a feature, probably not a bug. So even if you use the same actual prompt, sometimes the AI will give you a probably slightly different code. Build your foundational knowledge, as you said, the file formats, statistical methods, programming skills, biological principles, so that AI cannot replace. Connect with the community, follow YouTubers, me, and join forums and share your experience with AI tools. And remember, lastly, AI is your assistant, not your replacement. Your biological expertise and the critical thinking of what make AI generated code actually useful. And when used correctly, AI can actually 10x your. That's it for today. I hope you learned something, and I will see you next time. Happy learning.